Hi everybody, Tector here. Today we're gonna look at the BSL shader version 8, go through the settings and tweak the visual appearance to be more friendly to the eye during the gameplay. Keep in mind that there is no such thing as the best settings. The ones I recommend are carefully picked and they are meant to look more like vanilla Minecraft while having the enhanced shader look and a good overall performance for the different biomes, weather situations at day, during night, in caves, underwater, in the nether and so on. Make sure you have the correct version of Optifine and the BSL shader installed. The version I'm using is on the screen right now and there's also a download link in the description. Alright, let's go! Open the game menu, select Options, Video Settings, Shaders, then select your BSL shader and hit the shader options on the bottom right. First thing we have to do is to choose a profile to apply some basic settings. If your computer is amazeballs, then go with high or ultra, otherwise stick with medium or low. For this video, we're gonna go with high. Okay, let's start with lighting. Here we set the desaturation to low. This will prevent ores from changing their colors in dark places like caves, which can be really annoying. If you want to gain some FPS, then you can also completely turn this option off. Talking about FPS, you can further increase them by turning off the option colored shadows here on the left. Shadows in general have quite a big impact on performance. I recommend to set them not higher than medium, except of course if you're recording something with the replay mod. In that case, you can put that to high and also increase the shadow distance to 512. But if you play, I recommend the settings as shown here. Then we have ambient occlusion. This is another option that can be turned off if you are desperate for FPS. Choice is yours, I however will leave that on. That's it for lighting, let's go back and then continue with atmospherics. Here we turn off sky desaturation. That will not have a big visual impact, but lets you use sky packages without removing the intended coloring of the package. Then I like to choose a round sun and moon. If you do too, then remember to turn off the default sun and moon in the Minecraft settings, otherwise both textures will overlap. To reduce the very dominant light shafts, let's set the light shaft strength to 0.5. If you have a render distance below 15, I recommend turning on Distant Fade and set it to spherical. That adds a mist which patches up the holes of unrendered terrain. Okay, next let's go to the submenu Cloud Config. Here we set the thickness to low and the height to very high. That makes the world you're in look big and spacey. Then we set the opacity to 0.9 to let the sun and stars shimmer through the clouds, and we set the brightness to 2, which will keep the clouds white and fluffy. And done! Let's go back to select sky config. Here we set the horizon distance to very far and reduce the skybox brightness to 0.75. And with that, we are done in this part of the menu. Back to the shader options. We continue with World, where we only set the animation speed to 0.25. With that, plants and leaves won't shake like crazy anymore and be more pleasing to the eye. That, however, also makes the water surface very slow, which we will have to correct by going back and selecting the menu Water. Here we set the speed to 4.0. By the way, if you prefer small wrinkles on the water surface, you might want to select Normals Purlin and or adjust the surface with the options Bumpiness and Detail. I however prefer the Wally setting and will leave it there. On to the next option, we go back and continue with Post Effects. Here we reduce the bloom strength to 0.75. This will leave some atmospheric mist and a nice glow to light sources, but also compensates for the changes we are about to make. Then we reduce the lens flare strength to 0.5, so that the effect still is visible, but very subtle. That's it, let's head back. Alright, now we go to color grading and tone map and do some more profound changes. First, we increase the exposure to 0.25, which will make the dark areas a little bit brighter. Then we adjust the tone mapping to make colors more distinguishable and also to increase the contrast of bright areas and objects. We set the lower curve to 1.3, reduce the white curve to 1.5, and increase the upper curve to 1.5. Now we bring in some more vibrance. First, we reduce the saturation to 0.95 to not make it too colorful, and then we increase the vibrance to 1.2. And done! Back to the shader menu. I hope you're still with me, cause now we're gonna tackle the most important part, colors, and this will by far have the most impact on the looks. Here we influence the colorization for any given situation. I derive the following settings by measuring the colors in an editor, comparing them with the intended look in vanilla Minecraft, and fine-tuning them to keep the awesome BSL shader looks. Alright, let's start with lighting color. In Light Morning, we set blue to 100 and green to 172. That gives us a nice morning sun. One back and open Light Day. Here we set red to 184, blue to 148 and green to 176. We go back again and to the right we have Ambient Day. Set green to 140 and blue to 168. With that, the light during the day won't be overwhelmingly bright and bluish anymore. Okay, we go back and let's continue with Light Evening for a nice evening sun. Reduce red to 212 and green to 156. Then set the intensity to 1.3 and go back. In Ambient Evening, we reduce blue to 100. And back again and go to Light Night. Here we increase red to 164 and set the intensity to 1.45. Now the last thing to change is Ambient Night, where we set red to 180, blue to 200 and the intensity to 1.2. This makes the night a bit brighter, which gives us a better visibility, and it recolors the very bluish look to be a little bit more like vanilla Minecraft. Whew, finally done with this one. Okay, back to the color menu and select Block Light Color. Here we will make light sources less orange. Let's set red to 192, green to 168 and the intensity to 1.05. If emissive recolor is turned on, then I recommend to turn it off. It alters the appearance of light sources and makes everything look very orange. If, however, you are a fan of that, and I know some of you are, then of course you can go for it and turn it on. Good, next on the list is sky color. Here we increase red to 112 and the intensity to 1.2. Okay, back we go and up next is water. Let's give it a nice blue by setting red to 16, blue to 180, green to 120 and the intensity to 0.6. We are nearly there. Now we tackle the nether color. And here we start with nether wastes, which will determine the base coloring for the nether. Here we set red to 196, blue to 56, green to 80 and the intensity to 1.7. With that, the nether will be looking a bit more Minecrafty. Now we go to the Soul Sand Valley, where we set red to 116 and the intensity to 1.2. Nice! Go back and select Crimson Forest. Here we set red to 224, blue to 56, green to 60 and the intensity to 1.6. For the warped forest, we set red to 232, green to 196, and the intensity to 1.2. The basalt deltas can stay like they are. Okay, one more to go. Let's go back to the color menu and select End Color. Here we set green to 196 and the intensity to 1.2. However, I don't normally use the BSL shader in the end as it doesn't look that good. Whew, tell me in the comments what you like or don't like about the BSL shader, the presented settings or the video. Alright, time to hit the like button, enjoy the new settings and have a great time. See you in the next one. Bye bye!